co-ops, but there is no outcome. Even the people are ready to report the co-ops, but there is no solution from the co-ops for the incident reported. So it is a pathetic situation in India. Even though the woman ready to report, sometimes the woman itself, they're blamed by someone, or the cops are not taking appropriate care of that. Coming to another picture here, the sexual harassment cases in the workplace from 2014 to 2018. This is the major company's data, you know. In India, in Tamil Nadu, we have seen 105 cases of sexual harassment between the between 2014 to 18, the major big companies. These are reported cases. Okay. And in Karnataka, 111 cases. Then in Maharashtra, 147. Madhya Pradesh, 154. Then we have seen more number of cases in Uttar Pradesh. You see 726 cases of sexual assault or harassment between the 2014 to 18. You see the number of sexual assault in universities are more common in UP. Again, the number of sexual harassment in the big companies are more common in UP. I don't know what is the problem, but still the problem is there in the society, in the local society. The more number of things are happening in North. Okay, even the sexual assaults are happening in Delhi, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, everywhere. So you have to be very, very careful. And harassment among women at workplaces. Another study was published in the Indian Journal of Community Medicine says, most of the time, the harassments are happening between the age of 25 to 45. The vulnerable ages in work area. We have seen already in universities or colleges, the vulnerable ages almost from, what is that? Below 24, right? Okay, but here, the vulnerable age for sexual harassment at workplace is 25 to 45 age. And among all the profession, nurses are mostly sexually assaulted when compared to other profession, followed by sales girls. So they are targeting the nurses. Even though they are working in hospital with well-educated, even though they are working with well-educated people like doctors, very, very big people, but still the nurses are targeted easily. Okay, and followed by sales girls. And when compared to the socioeconomic status, mostly the upper middle class and lower middle class, equally they are targeted for sexual harassment. Because there is a, what is it? The upper class are not targeted mostly, and the lower class also not targeted that much. But upper middle class and lower middle class, the middle class people are, they're having a lot of commitment, lot of family issues. So in order to meet the family commitment, they have to go for the job. So that is one of the thing. So they are easily targeted by the assailants. Okay. And most of the time, whenever they have working experience of 1 to 10 years, they are easily targeted. Because for the people working in between the age of 1 year, working experience of 1 year means, initially they joined in the company, at that time they will not touch, they will not approach. But after a year, maybe after the next 10 years, the people are easily targeted. The women are easily targeted when up to the 10 years of working experience. After that, they may be a senior, so they will not approach the seniors, right? So these are the vulnerable people for easily targeted by the sexual assailants. Okay, so the report from the Western country says that 90% of those who say they have experienced harassment but never report it or take formal action. See, even Australia, it's a developed country, they have a good reporting system. Even though they have good reporting system, 90% of women, they are not reporting it. Or not, they are not taking any formal action. But in India, you see, we don't have any reporting system. We don't have much reporting system, or we don't have awareness about it. Now we can compare how much number will be, the percentage of people will be affected sexually in India. Okay. And 68 countries don't have law against sexual harassment. It is a pathetic situation. 68 countries do not have any law against sexual harassment. And this levies 235 million working women without legal recourse. So they have low legal provision for protecting themselves from the harassment. So there are about 235 million people, working women, they don't know what to do. They don't have legal provision. Even in India, we have the sexual provision only for harassment, but we don't have a provision for other non-sexual harassment. Even men also have the same problem, you know, harassment, right? It's a growing problem nowadays. The homosexuality is a very, very growing problem nowadays. And same-sex marriage. You know, maybe they will not target us because we are adult, we have experience, we have some society influence. Okay, they will not target us. Maybe they will target the youngsters and the children. Okay, especially the homosexual people, they will target only the boys, the child below age of 18. Okay, coming to where the sexual harassment is seen as the biggest issue. In Turkey, both women and men, around half of the people, they think the sexual harassment is the very biggest issue in their society. In India, 47% of men and women, they think it is a very big issue. But remaining 53, they say it is a natural thing. We can't avoid it. We can avoid. Only the 47 think it is a sexual harassment is the biggest issue. But remaining 53, still they have the mindset like it is a common. So we need lot of area like Chonakanj or what is that? The sexual streets like Thailand. We cannot provide. We are not doing that type of profession. Okay, mind control is very, very important. If you're not controlling your mind, we can't do anything. Okay, even in Mexico, 52% of women and 44% of men also think that is a very big issue. You see, even all the countries are having the problem. So most of the time, we don't know whether it is sexual harassment or not. They are not aware about it. As Sar said, Suresh previously said, a child was molested by some people, around 10 people, but she don't know whether it is a sexual harassment or not. Because a lack of awareness, we are not educating them. So here, there are different forms of sexual harassment. Even in the workplace, sometimes they will offer some benefits. So offering some benefits for a sexual favor is a harassment. If you're spending a weekend night with me, I will give you a promotion, means it is a kind of sexual harassment. If the particular woman is performing well, you can give according to their eligibility, according to the criteria, you can give the promotion or benefit. But giving a benefit for the sexual pleasure is an harassment. Then unwanted sexual advancements. They will often keep a touch somewhere else. So often they will try to touch or have bodily contact with you then and there. That is a form of sexual harassment. And threat. Okay, whenever they approach you for the sexual pleasure, sex, and you are steadily no, at the time they may threaten you. So it is a form of sexual harassment. Okay, and different visual, gesture, the bodily contact, or they may change the position, they will act a different way, showing hands or body movement. So all these things are considered as a suggestive gesture is known as harassment. Then verbal contact, a derogatory comments. The derogatory comments, maybe either direct comment or indirect comment, is considered as a sexual harassment. But most of the time, we used to neglect it. If you keep on neglecting such type of comments again and again, they will take advantage. We should know the true meaning of the comment, and you have to predict it. The prognosis is very, very important. In medical field, used to say prognosis. Prognosis means to predict in the future. So you have to think about the word, what they are using, whether they will take any advantage in future or not. So based on that, you have to take action. So the verbal conduct. And physical conduct like body position or touching. So that also is one type of sexual harassment. Okay. So mostly what they will do, they will try all the ways to attract you for sexual abuse. Sometimes they will do sexual assault, or sometimes they will attempt, or they will rape. And sexual harassment. Then they will do stalking. So stalking also one of very big problem actually. Then indecent exposure. Sometimes they will show unusual photos, the pornographic videos, or some sexual comments, okay, sex jokes. So all these are a form of sexual harassment. then degrading your sexual imaginary. Maybe they will degrade you. You are very fat. You are not looking good. You are very ugly. So like that, they make some sexual harassment and voyeurism. Yeah, cyber harassment. So trafficking. All these are different forms of sexual violence. Okay, and sexual exploitation is another very big problem. So you should know what are the different forms of sexual harassment. If they are doing sexual harassment, what are the different forms of sexual exploitation will happen? Okay. Then the sexual harassment includes an actual or attempted rape or sexual assault, whether they actually they did rape or attempted. You should know. Sometimes they will try. So try is an attempt. So it's a crime. Unwanted deliberate touching or leaning over or cornering or pinching. All these are sexual assault or harassment. Okay. And whenever they are cornering you in a particular area, you can go away. You can escape. So no other way for you. This is a type of sexual harassment. There are two types of cornering. One is physical cornering. Another one is mental cornering. You know, physical corner means they will lock you in a particular area, particular locality. Mental cornering means they will lock all your surroundings. Then, no other way, you have to approach the particular person for solving the issue. So at that time, they will take advantage. So you should know what is physical cornering, mental cornering, how they are targeting you. Then unwanted sexual teasing, jokes, remarks or questions. Okay, and whistling, normally we whistle, right? So whistling is one form of sexual harassment. Kissing sounds, howling, smacking lips also one type of sexual harassment. Touching on employee's clothing, hair or body is a kind of sexual harassment. You see, maybe they will touch the child, they touch the cloth. How is your cloth is very good, your hair is very shiny. They will pinch the chin. So it's a type of sexual harassment. Touching or robbing oneself sexually around another person is another form of sexual harassment. Nowadays, in the corporate culture, we have hugging. The hugging is also a kind of sexual harassment, you know. There are two types of hugging. Sometimes the hugging is just a shoulder touch. But sometimes they will take advantage, they will try to touch your the front part of your body. It's not a hugging, it's a kind of sexual harassment. But normally they think that if let's say for example, if you keep on hugging a guy in your organization and you are thinking that it is not a sexual harassment, it is a social culture, finally that particular guy will approach you in a wrong way. Yes, it's common because you are allowing them to touch your body. So it's a kind of different forms of sexual harassment. So what will happen when you face any sexual harassment? Physiologically you may face some problem like headache, lethargy, or sexual problem. Initially, you are sexually harassed. You had an experience of sexual harassment. Initially, you can't think more. So headache will be there. Lethargy, sexual problem. You cannot cooperate with your partner. Some gastrointestinal problem. Dermatological. Some people may think itching. You know the Mogan movie, you know, Mounaragam. The Mounaragam, the movie, the heroine used to say, I have some form of itching when you are touching me. Okay. I have some form of unusual sensation on my skin when you are touching me. So it's a kind of dermatological reaction, you know, the allergic reactions. Phobia and panic reactions will be there. Sleep disturbance. You cannot sleep properly. Nightmare. All on the sudden you will wake up and you will not get sleep. Weight fluctuation will be there. Psychologically, you may be depressed, anxiety or shock. You may have anger or fear or frustration because you went for a job, but someone is approaching you wrongly. So frustration, then irritability, insecurity and embarrassment, feeling of betrayal. Then finally you make it confusion, whether I should work in the organization or not, what to do, that approach. Feelings of being powerless. Yes, if your senior manager is approaching you in different way, sexually or for sexual pleasure, you may think that you are powerless. If you have good support, you can do it. So shame, self consciousness, you lose consciousness, low self-esteem, you may feel guilty, self-blame and isolation. Okay, so all these problems will happen when you are being sexually assaulted. And the career related effects, like you may decrease job satisfaction, you went for some purpose but you lost your reputation, so you may have lack of satisfaction. Unfavorable performance for evaluation, you may lose your job or promotion. Sometimes a change in career goals, jobs or educational programs. Sometimes because of this sexual harassment, you are not ready to face your colleague again and again, or you will try to avoid the particular guy, so you will take absence, you take leave, absenteeism. Sometimes you travel from the work or school, drop in academic or work performance due to stress. So all these problems will happen when you face any sexual harassment. So you have to notice each and everything. Maybe some people will have a mild symptoms, some people have moderate symptoms or severe symptoms. So according to that, you have to check. If someone is approaching you and you feel very anxious, means that relationship is not good. If someone is approaching you and you are discussing with them and you are talking with them, and this make a conducive environment, means it's a good. So mind is good, both are thinking good vibration. If someone is approaching you and you feel that the vibration is not good, you have to be very, very careful. Okay, what can I do if I think I'm being sexually harassed at work? First thing is, you have to document it. The documentation is very, very important. If you are reporting verbally, they will not accept. They may say different story. So you need a document, either it is a video or photo, or maybe a written papers or what it may be. So you need a document, evidence, and make it clear that it is unwelcome. Whenever someone is approaching you for the sexual pleasure or sexual things, you have to say no. You can say, that kind of conversation is inappropriate in the workplace. It makes me uncomfortable. You have to express your feeling. It is uncomfortable for me, and it makes all the other women uncomfortable. Please stop doing it, you can say. Or you can say, you should not communicate in that way. Sometimes they will try to communicate in a different way. That is the first point of approach. You can say, inserting needle in the banana. Like that, they will introduce all the bad things in the smooth way. So you have to inform them, you should not communicate in that way. It is offensive to me. Please stop talking to me in that way. And you can say, I don't want to date you. The first moment itself, you have to say, I'm not that kind of lady. I'm not that kind of guy. Okay. Even, I faced some problem actually, you know. When I was traveling from Coimbatore to Madurai, when I was studying my undergraduation, I was traveling from Coimbatore to Madurai in night bus from Singanallur to Madurai Arapalayam. Once a bus crossed Ottanchatram, a guy sitting next to me, he approached me in a different way. At the moment itself, I scolded him. I took my bag and went to near the driver's seat and began the driver's seat. I sat and I didn't get sleep, you know, on that day. It was happened 15 years before. It was, I think, in 2002, almost 18 years before. So why I'm telling this, not only women, even men are also targeted. You see, so at the moment itself, you have to say, I'm not ready to date with you. And do not give me any more compliments. Sometimes they will give compliments, maybe a gift, or maybe they will give some form of promotion or increment, something they will give. Always they will keep on appreciating you. You're doing good, doing good, doing good. Even for simple work also, they will appreciate. You may think it is a kind of appreciation, but no. Sometimes it will go beyond the limit and they may take advantage. You have to say that it makes me uncomfortable. Okay. And if you face any problem, consult your friend or superior or the concerned person for the reporting or authorities or police or a lawyer to take this incident in a better way. And be remember that you are a role model, make a change. Okay. How employees' anti-harassment behavior changed nowadays? Because there are a lot of people who are ready to report now. So the anti-harassment behavior changed now. Now they are speaking up more when uncomfortable. So they are speaking up more when you're uncomfortable. They will speak more. And discussing social issues more openly. Okay. And calling up bad behavior more. Then telling fewer insensitive jokes. Okay. And willing to listen more. So now the anti-harassment behavior has changed almost all the people with a different mindset. Okay, now the approach also changed. So if you face any problem, if you think that the particular incident is not good and you feel that the particular incident is coming under the sexual harassment, you should take 10 steps to prevent the sexual harassment. First thing is you have to understand what is the definition for sexual harassment, whether it is sexual harassment or not. Okay, I will give you some example like unwanted joke, yes sir, offensive words on clothing and unwelcome comments. It's a kind of sexual harassment. Touching any parts of your body, this is scratching or patting. Sometimes they will pat on the back. It's a kind of sexual harassment. A repeated request for the dates. Even though you said, I don't want to date with you, they keep on pestering you. Shall we go out? Shall we go for coffee? Shall we go for dinner? Shall we go for tea? Okay, so it will create a lot of pressure. This is a kind of sexual harassment. Transmitting or posting emails or pictures of sexual or other harassment related nature. Yes, sharing the jokes or images in the WhatsApp or social media to you. One of my friend, she's working in BJP, okay, BJP in the district level secretary. Okay, this is just my Facebook friend. She reported last week actually, there are a lot of people, because she's in a very visible area and a lot of people are giving Facebook request. So she's accepting all the requests. Once she accepted the request, they are coming directly to the messenger. In the messenger, they are asking us, what you are doing, what is your work, how is your husband, are you married, all these things. Do you think this is necessary? If you see, I am accepting you as a friend only for the social media, only to share my views. Okay, what I am posting in that Facebook image or in the Facebook, if you accept, if you like it, you click the like button. If you didn't like, go away, no problem. But it is not a right, it is not a way to ask me about my family background, about me and everything. Correct. So there are a lot of even though she's very, very famous in the social media, very, famous person, but she also having a lot of issues. You know? Okay. So playing sexually suggestive music, there are a lot of people are doing that. The songs with the different meanings, double meaning. So incorporate training on harassment and discriminatory treatment in your workplace. First, you have to understand the definition. Then you have to incorporate training on harassment and discriminatory treatment in your workplace. So now this STTP is a kind of training. Now the people, once the people attended this training, they can easily understand what is sexual harassment, how can overcome sexual harassment, what is sexual health, what is sex education. So all these things can come to know. So either we have to we have to conduct some training to make them very familiar for all the colleagues. Ensure your workplace has a sexual harassment policy. There is another thing, we have to ensure that whether we have any sexual harassment policy in our workplace or not. Then raise awareness. So it is the most effective form of prevention. Once the sexual assault happened, taking precautionary measures or taking a legal action over the assailants or protecting the victim is not sufficient. Before that, you have to create awareness. What is the sexual assault? What will happen? Okay, so the lack of awareness is a problem. They don't know what is sexual assault, what is sexual harassment. They don't know what will happen if they are committing any sexual assault. So the legal aspects they don't know, because of the legal, what is a lack of awareness on the legal proceedings, they are committing a lot of mistakes. If they know the proceedings, they will not do that. Okay, so have clear harassment reporting procedure in your workplace is very, very essential. That harassment report should be easily accessible. The reporting should be easily accessible. It should be very transparent. Okay, incorporate staff welfare into the review meeting and appraisals. So whenever you do any meeting or appraisals, incorporate your staff and ask their opinion and get all the opinion. Make the procedures very formal and very, what is that, visible and more friendly. Okay, for reporting, and deal with any allegations and concern immediately. If someone is reporting something about the sexual assault, we have to deal it very, very fast. Anything will happen anytime, right? So deal it very fast and find out the reasons and come out with the solutions as soon as possible. And next point, have a dedicated person in place to review any allegations. You should have a dedicated person. Most of the corporate companies are having the dedicated person to deal all these issues. In the HR, they may have a dedicated person. Okay. Now we used to say whistleblowing, you know, the whistleblower. So there are some in corporate companies, we have a system like that. So we need a dedicated person to deal all these issues and make sure that there is a zero tolerance policy. Whether the assailant is a manager or a the CEO of the company or a low-level labor or the team member or a manager or a colleague, whatever it may be, maybe the principal or professor or dean, whatever it may be, there is zero tolerance policy. We should not accept. Okay, regardless of the employee stature within the organization, we have to take appropriate action on the complaint. Okay, if deemed necessary, we can make a complaint to the police and protect the victim. Okay, and report any concerns immediately. So whenever you have any concerns or anything regarding, it is not necessary to be assaulted. Maybe it's a threat. Even though if you face any threat, report immediately. Okay, so all these 10 steps you're supposed to do it. And the main problem for not reporting to the concerned authorities is lack of knowledge about the sexual harassment and the reporting system. According to the International Labour Organization, they have the reporting system like preventive and reporting to sexual harassment workplace. So this gives a clear idea how the labours can report the sexual harassment, what is different types of sexual harassment, where they can report, how they can protect themselves from others, okay, how they can maintain their anonymity. So all these things they can get. And according to the Ministry of Women and Child Development, they have a separate system for reporting the sexual harassment at workplace. So they have released a handbook. So from this handbook was framed according to the Act, Prevention and Prohibition of Retrieval Act 2013. So according to this act, so you can get a lot of information about the sexual harassment, the punishment, everything. What are the different type of punishment? Okay, and there are a lot of books are available like a sexual harassment, how to prevent sexual harassment at the workplace. So you have, everyone should have, maybe, I'll give you a simple idea. This book is very, very cheaper. You can buy the book and keep it in your home. Maybe you may have a boy or girl as a child. So ask them to read it. They know what is sexual harassment. Okay, what is different forms of sexual harassment? So what will happen if they are doing sexual harassment? So the punishment, law, everything they can come to know. Then they may have fear if they are committing some mistakes, they will be begin the bar according to the law. So everything should be taught to the students. Okay, and in government of India, the government of India, according to the Ministry of Women and Child Development, they have the she box. The she box, not only for the she, even men also can report. Actually, so if you see any sexual harassment at your workplace, either it has happened to you or to your neighbor or maybe to your colleague, you can report. It's not been necessary to be the victim can report. Anyone can report. So you can go to the she box, that is Minister of Women and Child Development. You can lodge your complaint and you can check the status of your complaint. So what is the progress? See, everything you can see. Here, your anonymity will be completely protected. Okay, sometime the, even the gents also, there'll be some problem. Sexual harassment will be there, either from the management or sometime from either a higher authority. Okay, they will ask you to, can you prevent this one? I will do this one further. They will ask different things, you know what I mean? So if you face any of this problem, because if your manager is expecting something sexual, what is a benefit from you, or if the manager is asking you to asking you to arrange something else, so you can report it. So all the sexual related, harassment related matters, you can report here and you can check your progress of the report and the complaint. Okay. According to the Indian Penal Code, the Indian Constitution on Sexual Harassment, so it is a fundamental rights of a woman to equality under Article 14. So it is under article says that all the men and women are equal. So the sexual harassment clearly violates the fundamental rights. Okay. And according to Article 15, if you are working, the prohibition of discrimination of grounds on religion, race, caste, or workplace, anything can be reported. Okay. So it is the sexual harassment that violates the fundamental rights of you. So you have all the rights. You have the rights to life. You have the rights to your practice. You have the rights to your profession. You can carry out any occupation or trade or business. So all these things, your rights are protected by Article 21. So Article 15, 14 and 15 says that, so the sexual harassment violates your fundamental rights. But you can do any business. It is your life. You have all the rights to lead your life. You can do any type of business or your occupation or any trade according to Article 21. They cannot say you are a woman or you are men. You are not supposed to do it. It is your rights. At the same time, the Article 16 protects you and it gives a right to safe environment free from sexual harassment. So these Article 14, 15, 21 and 19(1)(g) make sure that it is your rights to do the job and to make the working environment is very safe from sexual harassment. So don't think it is only for men, women. It is also for men. Sexual harassment behavior, it should be protected. Okay. So according to the IPC on sexual harassment, in 2013, the Criminal Law Amendment Act was framed. Okay. So this act prevent all forms of sexual harassment. And according to Section 354A of the Indian Penal Code, this code was framed under 1860 year. And according to this penal code, under the Section 354A, you will be completely protected from the sexual harassment. If someone is committing something sexually, or if you are sexually assaulted, the assailants will get lot of imprisonment. Okay, we will see one by one. According to Section 354A, the sexual harassment includes unwelcome physical contact or advancements, including unwanted explicit sexual overtures or any type of the sexual images, sharing pornography or any jokes or any videos or sexual remarks. These are coming under the category of Section 354A. If someone is doing this type of sharing, maybe you may not aware about it. You think that it is just, she's my friend or he's my friend, I'm sharing pornography or some videos or some sexual jokes. If the particular person don't like your sharings or don't like that image, they can go for any legal proceedings. You may think they are your close friend. You cannot predict when they will become enemy. So maybe now you are sharing, maybe after 3 years, 4 years later, they will take that particular image and they may say, he sexually assaulted me. She sexually assaulted me. So according to this 354A, the punishment is up to 3 years in prison and a fine. 3 years will be under the jail. We get the bar. Maybe now it will be okay. You are sharing because he's your close friend or he's your close friend. You are sharing your some photos or videos. Maybe in future we can predict it. There is a possibility. Okay. And according to section 354B, forcing a woman to undress is a common nowadays. It's very, very common in the youth. It is very common. They will talk like a friend. They will initially they will approach like a friend. They will talk like you, and they will start audio calling, then video calling. Sometimes they will ask you to undress. It's a kind of crime. For this crime, under section 354B, 3 to 7 years of imprisonment and fine. Okay. You don't know what will happen in future. Maybe now you may do all our you to please your partner, you may do all our whatever they want. Maybe in future they will take that video and they will put it in the social media, or they may do some other problems. Correct. So everything is punishable offense. According to section 354C, watching or capturing image of a woman without her consent is a punishment, punishable offense. It is considered voyeurism. Voyeurism means watching or capturing image of a woman. It doesn't mean that you have to capture a nude image. Even if you are capturing some image, she's sitting on a table and she's doing some work. You are capturing the image of a woman from the backside or from somewhere else without her consent. She can file a complaint, 354C. According to that, you may get 1 year to 3 years of imprisonment and maximum of 3 to 7 years of imprisonment and a fine. You may think that this is just a photo. I'm taking a photo. Okay. You can't predict the mindset of people. If she feels that you have committed some mistakes, she can file a complaint. According to section 354D, following a woman and contacting her or trying to contact her repeatedly is offense. Monitoring a woman using the internet or any form of electronic communication is known as stalking. So any form of electronic communication, sharing images or videos or whatever, is a stalking. So that is a considered a crime or a punishable offense. According to 354D, if you are following a woman, either through electronic follow or physical follow, whatever it may be, we will get punishment. You will get punishment for the first conviction up to 3 years. If you are repeating again, you will get punishment up to 5 years of imprisonment and a fine. If we know the rules, we have to educate our kids about the rules. Not only the sex education, we have to educate along the rules. If you are doing this one, you will be punished. You will be committing a crime. You will be punishable as per the law. Correct. Whenever we touch a fire, we know that the fire will burn our hands. That's why we are not touching the fire. So we know the consequences of fire. If we know the consequences of committing a mistake, they will not do it. Most of the crimes are happening because they don't know the consequences. So we have to educate our kids, we have to educate our students about all the moral values, about all the rules and regulations about this crime. Then they will not do the mistake. So there is the act, that is the Sexual Harassment Act, can be divided into two. Before the Visakha scenario, after the Visakha scenario. So before the Visakha scenario, even though the article preventing the sexual harassment was framed in the 1860s, but we don't have much provision to protect a woman from the sexual harassment. There are a few sections like 354 and 509 of sexual harassment, but there is no much improvement from the Sexual Harassment Act. So after the sexual, after the post Vikas scenario, the case was filed in the Rajasthan court and they conducted an elaborate discussion about it. And in 2013, they framed sexual harassment of women at workplace, that is a prevention of prohibition and redressal Act 2013. So this act protects a woman from the workplace from all forms of sexual harassment. Either bodily touch or verbal abuse or whatever it may be. So it protects a woman from sexual assault from the workplace in all forms of harassment. Okay, so this is very, very essential. We have to educate them how to what is Visakha scenario and what is the Prohibition Act and everything. Then coming to the scenario, so we have seen what is sex education, why it is necessary, and what is sexual health, why it is necessary for the youth, how to teach teens with the sexual assault, the children with sex education, all these things. And we have seen different forms of sexual harassment at workplaces, and if they are committing sexual harassment workplaces, what are the things will happen, what are the legal proceedings will happen, how they will be punished, what are the punishment, everything we have seen. Okay, now share your opinion with me. I will give you a scenario. Like the first scenario, assume that we are a parent of a 7 year old, maybe a boy or girl. Okay, assume that you are in each and every family we have a boy or girl in this age. So assume that you are a parent of 7 year old boy or girl, and that one day you find your child playing doctor with a playmate, with a friend, playmate of the same age of other sex. So your boy or girl is playing with the neighbor or the playmate of opposite sex, but suddenly both have lowered their pants, even though in the same age group, 7 years old, but both are opposite sex. Suddenly they lower their pants and they seem to be involved in visibly exploring each other's bodies. It's a common, you know, it's a very common in the childhood. They don't know the consequences, but all of a sudden they will remove their pants, they will undress, and they will show their body. Okay, in that case, how will you respond? What will be your response? Do you think, would you react differently according to the sex of your child? If the boy is your if the child is your son, how will you respond? Suppose if the child is your daughter, how will you respond? What about if the other child was the same sex of your child? Suppose if both are same, if both are boys and they undressed, if both are girl, they undressed, what you will do? What do you think? You can unmute your mic and you can share your opinion. You can unmute yourself. There is no right or wrong. Okay, here we don't have any answer for whether it's a right or wrong. Just share your opinion. What do you think if your child playing with another child, both are opposite sex, and suddenly they undressed? What you will do?
Sir, I will start to scold my kid. You okay. Should not do like this hereafter. And okay. I will suggest and advise our playmate. Okay. And I will inform it to their parents also.
Okay.
So I feel uneasiness when they do like that.
Yes. It's uneasy for the parents. Yes. Then any other opinion? Anyone? Just open your mic, no problem. We're not going to see your face, nothing. We are in education field, we should not hesitate to talk. You can unmute and discuss. It's a kind of discussion, okay? There is no right or wrong. Anybody? Anyone want to discuss anything? So as Sir said, actually, it is uneasiness for the parents to see the kids because they are playing in an open area and they are removing the dress suddenly. Okay, it actually, they don't know the consequences what they are doing, but simply they will remove the pants and they will show the body parts. They will play with the organs, you know. So it is not actually. It is not a welcoming thing. So at that time, instead of scolding them, we have to educate them. It is not a good. Okay, normally in our childhood they used to say, "Don't remove your pant, otherwise the the birds will come and hit your private parts."
Yes, yes,
Right,
sir.
they used to say, because they never scored us, but they used to say in different way. Okay, so it's a kind of approach. Instead of scolding, we have to inform both the parents. Yes, as you said correctly, we have to inform both the parents, your child as well as your the playmate or parents. This is not good sign. So we have to educate them. So we have to educate them in an appropriate way. Okay, in your opinion? But actually, beating is not beat. We should not beat. Beating will make them very vulnerable.
Okay, sir.
Any other opinion from anyone? Okay. If not, we'll go to the next scenario. Okay. The scenario says that assume that we are a parent of a teenager who asks, "How do I know when I should have sex?" The tricky question, you know. Your teenager asks, "How do I know when I should have sex?" What would be your answer and why? It's a tricky question. No? How can you answer?
Can you educate them, sir?
Yes,
or giving some related books to learn something from?
Yes. If you are able, you can explain. Otherwise, you can give some books to read. Okay, but even the books also for the teenagers, we can't expect the grasping power is good. It's up, good. Depends on the child, right?
Yes.
So we can't expect they will get appropriate answer for that. Okay, any other method? Because the teenagers are very, very curious. They wanted to know everything. Okay, how we can address this type of issue? The question is very transparent. How do I know when I should have sex? Okay, so sex is very, very different. You know, yesterday I read on news, whether it is true or wrong, I don't know. A 7-year-old boy sexually assaulted a 5-year-old girl. They filed a complaint, you know. 7-year-old boy, how they can molest a 5-year-old girl?
Media, sir.
Yeah. We can take it as a different way, actually. A 7-year-old boy, maybe the 7-year-old boy touching the body parts, maybe touching somewhere or kissing. It is a kind of how kissing your sister. Okay. So they don't know what they're going to do. 7-year-old boy, how they don't know it's sex. But yesterday the report says that the 7-year-old boy molested 5-year-old girl. So here, they will not be any vulgar. They don't have any negative impact on their mind, negative thinking on the mind. But simply they may have some opinion. They may have some bodily attraction. Okay. So in this case, how do I know when I should have sex? We can educate them. You can have your legal sex after your marriage. So legal sex after your marriage is appropriate. But you are eligible to have sex once you attain the age of, what is it, the puberty. So the puberty for a woman is in terms of the menstruation cycle. After the menstruation cycle, she can have a sex. So for a man, for a boy, after a certain age, it will show some bodily changes. They can have a sex. But you are eligible to have a sex after the puberty in men and women. But the legal sex is allowed after the age of, it's illegal. If you're having sex with your partner, your married partner, that is illegal sex. So always legal sex is good for you, for the society, and for everyone. If you are committing illegal sex, legal sex is with a partner. If you are having illegal sex, you will be behind the bar according to the section. Correct. So you have to educate them in the proper way. This is legal sex, this is illegal sex. Illegal sex you can have anytime. But the consequences for illegal sex is these are the things. The article 354, A, B, C, D, E. A lot of sections are there, clauses are there. So you have to educate them. If you know the consequences, they will not do. But their question is, how do I know when should I have sex? You can have sex once you attend the puberty. But you have to answer them. It is your, what is eligibility. But the eligibility doesn't mean that you are legally qualified. So that can be given only through proper sexual education. Okay. If you are not telling that, no, you are eligible to have sex, but you can have sex only after marriage, then they will say, why? Why should I try after marriage? Why can't I try now? Great. I'm eligible now. Why should I have sex after marriage? Why can't I do it now? So if you are not informing the consequences, 100% they will try. So you have to inform the consequences. That is appropriate way of education. Okay. Coming to another question. Now we can share your opinion. What happens when no one directly cast affront with you, but passed some sexual comments? They directly didn't approach you, but they are passing some sexual comments or commented about your looks behind your back. So there's someone, maybe X or Y, he is not directly approaching you for the sexual pleasure or sexual harassment, but indirectly they are making some comments and they are commenting on your looks, okay, behind yourself. Do you think, will this also qualify as a sexual harassment?
Yes, sir. This is kind of sexual harassment.
Yes, this is a kind of sexual harassment. It's a punishable offense. Yes. Even though they are not informing directly, they are not commenting in front of you, maybe they will comment with their friends and you will come to know that information later. So it's a kind of sexual harassment. It's not only for the female, even for the male. It's a kind of sexual harassment. It's a mental torture, you know. It will create an untold pain, mental agony. So gossiping at work about the look of a woman who works in the same workplace is indeed a dangerous and is illegal. So hereafter, we should not do that. Correct? Okay. The question two, so Priya, it's just a common name. Okay. So Priya is a new hire in a company. There is a lot of work in the organization. And a superior or the manager often requests her to stay in office and work late night to complete the task at hand. So the Priya is a new hire in the company, new staff. The manager asking her to stay overnight, maybe late night, up to late night, to complete the task. She finds that this is too stressful and disturbing and wants to make a complaint for sexual harassment. The manager asking her to work, maybe repeatedly he sees the manager is asking to work overnight or to stay in the office to complete the task. Okay. And she feels that it is a kind of sexual harassment. Do you think such claim qualify the sexual harassment?
Yes, sir. This is a kind of sexual harassment.
Okay. What about others? Dear team members, what do you think? Do you think it's a sexual harassment? Actually, this is not a sexual harassment. I will explain you. Here, the manager or the superior is not asking any sexual pleasure. Because sometimes the task will be more. Sometimes we can see whenever we have the AICT inspection or the PCI inspection or the UGC inspection, we are working overnight. Okay, maybe in the usual days, normal days, we vacate after 5 o'clock or 5:30, we will vacate or we will leave to home. We will leave the office to home. But whenever we have the inspection time, we will be having a lot of workload. We have to prepare a lot of documents, NBI accreditation, so many things. At that time, the manager may ask you, can you stay late night to complete the task. Okay, maybe you will go very late, maybe 2 days, 3 days, or 4 days, maybe a week, you will work late night. Here, the manager is not at all asking you to satisfy him or her with a sexual pleasure. He don't commit any body contact. He is not verbally abusing you. He is not physically abusing you. Just he is asking to stay at office late night and complete the task. So it is not a sexual harassment, and she cannot file any complaint according to the penal IPC for the sexual harassment case. So the claim is not sustainable, as the threat was not of a sexual nature, but purely based on the business need, that is achieving assigned business target. So it's not a sexual harassment. Okay. Okay. Come to the third question. Miss Priya works in a law firm where a senior partner of the firm usually makes remarks at her appearance and dress, specifically demanding her to wear certain attire that makes her more attractive. Aggrieved by the act, she files a complaint for sexual harassment. That is, she's working in a law firm, and the law firm, sometimes they may meet the business people. The business people, and sometimes we have to go in appropriate attire. Okay, but here the manager or the firm company owner, he's telling the senior partners, telling that demanding her to wear a certain attire that makes her more attractive. Okay, and whether this claim is sustainable under sexual harassment or not. He's not asking anything. The senior partner is not asking anything, just asking her to wear something, some good dress to make her more attractive. Do you think it is a sexual harassment? Is it possible for Ms. Priya to file a case against sexual harassment? Do you have any answer? No, whether it's right or wrong, just you think yourself, because the lack of knowledge is giving room for others to commit mistakes. Because we don't know whether it is sexual harassment or not. So the dilemma, giving more chance for the assailants to take advantage. What do you think about it?
Sexual harassment only, sir.
Yes, it's 100%. It is a kind of sexual harassment. For a business, you can ask people to work more time. The professional attire is good. You can ask them to wear a professional attire, maybe a normal professional attire. But what is the need for more attractive? Why the woman need to attract the company people, or the colleague, or the partner? It's not a business. What is the need to attract? It's not a product to sell, to decorate the people, decorate the item to be more attractive for the selling purpose. So here it is 100% is sexual harassment. Asking people to come with a good, neat dress is not a matter. Okay, we are conducting a STTP program, or we are conducting a conference, we are conducting a seminar. Okay, all the faculty should come with office attire, a neat, good, attractive attire. It's common. But if a particular faculty is pointed out, and we are asking the particular faculty to come with an appropriate, more attractive attire, means it is kind of sexual harassment. So any kind of sexual remarks, whether direct or indirect, constitute sexual harassment under the Sexual Harassment Act, is considered as sexual harassment. So this is a form of sexual harassment. Okay. So come to the take-home message. Be aware of the different forms of sexual harassment, because we don't know. Because lack of knowledge about the sexual harassment, we have dilemma whether it is sexual harassment or not. If you don't have much knowledge about whether it is coming under sexual harassment or not, read the books or read the content from the authenticated sources for the different forms of sexual harassment. Do report if you face any problems or sexual harassment immediately to the concerned officer. okay, and have a sound knowledge of basic sexual harassment rules and regulations. We should have have sound knowledge on the basic sexual harassment rules and regulations. Not only us, even it is essential for the students, teenagers, and adolescents. If they know the basic rules and regulations, they will not commit any crime. And always encourage them, both men and women, to be bold to face any situation, okay, because nothing beyond our limit. So we have to be very, very bold to face any situation and make the environment more safer and more conducive for everyone. And most importantly, as a teacher, we have to play a role as a role model. Okay, so we have to play a role as a role model, educate our children, our students, all this problem associated with the sexual harassment, what is sex education, what is sexual health, what is sex harassment, and what are the punishable offense, what are the different sections for the sexual harassment. Then if you're educating them, they will not do any mistakes, they will not commit any mistakes or sexual harassment in the future. Okay, thank you. If you have any query, you can ask me.
Participants, if you have any queries, you can interact with sir. Participants,
do you have any queries? If you have any queries, you can chat with me directly. Otherwise, you can put it in the chat box. See, most of the time, you see, there are a lot of people committing mistakes, you know, with or without a knowledge. You know, the Polachi case recently, yeah, last year, I think.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
This is because one thing is they have money. There are very big shots people. The people are from very good background, economic background. So they don't know what to do. They have money. So they are easily targeting the vulnerable people. The vulnerable people means college students, school students, those are single parents. So they are targeting these people and they are making videos and they are getting money from them and investing their money to target more people. One thing, they are sexual pleasure. And the another thing is cruel mind. They wanted to spoil other people. Not even one or two. There are hundreds of people suffered because of sexual assault and harassment. But I don't know what will happen in future, whether they will be punished or they will be escaped.
Someone self-committed suicide, sir.
Yeah.
Ladies.
This is because of lack of awareness. If we know the crime, if we know the punishment, if you are committing this crime, this is a punishment, you will not do it. The main thing is most nowadays the youth, especially the 90s and 2000 kids, they are not giving respect for our family values. You know that? Previously used to say in the village, used to say, okay, he belongs to that family, his son, his daughter. So whenever we commit anything, before committing anything, we used to think about, if you're committing this one, it will spoil our family name, spoil our parents' name. We used to give more value for our family, our tradition. That is not there actually. The core value we missed. Do you have any doubts or any queries?
Thank you, sir. Thank you on behalf of PA College management, principal, HOD, and on my own behalf, I would like to thank you for your more informative information. And definitely we will follow and we will teach our students. Yes, you explained many question and answers. in this concern. It will open the participant's door to mind. The feeling that doubts is resolved. It released many misconceptions. The body secret is understood. Our hesitation and dizziness disappeared. New feeling is blooming. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity. And thank you to the management of PA College of Engineering and Technology. Then thank you for the coordinator, Chitra ma'am, and also Suresh sir, and all the participants. Okay. So we are the role model. Okay. We are the role model not only for our kids, and we are the role model for the next generation. If you are playing our role good, we'll take it as a role model, and they will perform well in their academic as well as their personal life. So thank you everyone for the opportunity. Wish you all success.
Thank you, sir.
Sorry, sir. Can I cut the call?
Sir, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Participants, let us join after the lunch. Session will start by 2:00. Please fill your feedback of today's session, morning session. It is the 13th and 14th session, day 4. I have posted a Google form. Kindly fill it.
Thank you.